Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Indiana Hoosiers and the St. John's Red Storm. And here are two of the players we'll be tracking, and I'm sure our viewers as well. And our starting lineup.
Wow, Gus, the matchup at center position should be really a good one. Sit back. Definitely two of the more skilled big men in the game tonight. They will be the difference makers.
Let's check out how these teams are going to set the tempo, Raph.
Every game you have to pick your areas of focus, Gus. Figure out what's going to help your team win and you execute that.
So here we go. Looking for a good shot. Shots up. He can't get it to go.
It's mine.
The Red Storm set up for a round one.
That's tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate and kick.
In the post. In the lane. And he can't get the bounce. Ivy handles the pass. Both teams are looking to get something going here. Holland handles the feed. He shoots from the corner.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Copeland receives the pass. Off the mark.
And lays it in.
Marshall receives the ball. Fires. Nice look.
Bang.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're just tuning in, thanks for joining us tonight. Gus Johnson here alongside Bill Raftery. Can't connect from the three-point line. And we'll head back down to the other end. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They've just got to be completed.
The Hoosiers working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Turnover by the freshman. Lobs it inside. Shots off.
Great inside control.
The Hoosiers set up into their 4-around-1 offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
He strokes it. No.
What a coach will be happy with that effort.
The low post. Jump shot. He missed it.
Look for the outlet.
On the wing. Fires. The freshman. Marshall is what many people may call a complete post player in that he can kind of do it all.
Gus, he's got a pretty good all-around game. He can step out 15, knock it down, and can score with his back to the hoop.
Shots off. Cleans the glass. They would like to get it inside to the low block. And he gets it. A terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
Entry pass in the paint.
How about that elevation?
Oh. on the outside.
Inside.
In the post. In the lane. He can't get it to go.
What a rebound. I own it.
Heat check time from long range. And he can't get the bounce. Pushes it. This guy can light things up in a hurry. He's got a scorer's mentality.
Gus, he's definitely a pure scorer. And when he gets going and is hot, he can easily go for 30.
In the post, in the lane. On the outside.
English on it.
How about him taking it to the cup, Bill?
Those aggressive drives are what propels this offense. There's no reason why they shouldn't continue to do this.
Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. Jump shot.
How about that?
In the post. He got it up and in. He fires it up. Up and in. Ha ha! On the outside. The senior. Dump it inside.
Look at that block. Terrific.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Up a long range shot.
Oh!
On the outside. He rejects it. Off the mark.
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
Got it in the low block. He fires away. No. Will he get back up with it? And he lays it up and in. On the inside. Shots off.
Look to outlet.
Out on the left wing. Shots up. He drains the three. On the right side. 8 minutes left on the game clock. Heat check time from long range.
He got it.
The Hoosiers did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
They got the ball to the big guy at the high post, and the D just couldn't react in time, Gus. That's often the case when the ball goes into that area of the court.
In the post. Jump shot. Shots off. Grabs the rebound. The Hoosiers are controlling the pace of the game.
They're doing a terrific job at playing their game, really making a conscious effort to control the tempo and imposing their will on the opposition.
Answer. Meeks is certainly making his presence felt there.
You have to be able to put a body on him. Easier said than done. He's such a tough guard because he really bangs you and finishes strong down on the box.
He strokes it. He missed it. Pulls it down. We are at the 7 minute mark. On the play. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus. Gus, without a doubt, this will be an emotional year for him, but the key is to stay focused on the task at hand. There'll be a time to reflect at the end of the season. His team needs him to perform at his best now.
Rims off.
Big time presentation at the rim. He made himself bigger by extending his arms.
They would like to get it inside to the low block. He can't get it to go. And the ball is out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. You know, Raph, this guy has really elevated his game today.
He's been a monster so far. He's been getting involved wherever he can, making the most of all his chances. He's been fun to watch.
The Hoosiers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Dump it inside. And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
At the line. Gotta make the freebies, Billy. Foul shot, no good. Now they work it around the perimeter. The junior. The Hoosiers, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
On the left side. And lays it in. Great job of occupying the high post. I think that's why they were able to get that basket.
They got the ball into the most precious area on the court. You're right, Gus. The high post is an area that's just so hard to defend.
On the wing. Dials up a long-range shot. Bang! Got it from three. Dump it inside.
Look at that block! Terrific reaction.
Swatted away. That goes out of bounds, but can stay at this end. They're set to throw it in from the side. the Hoosiers running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
We're at the 5-minute mark. In the post. Jump shot. And hits. The Hoosiers on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Let's check out this picture-perfect Jay one more time.
He really knows what to do when he gets his hands on the ball. Big-time dagger.
Looking for a good shot. Boom, he jams it. Get it down on the low block. Fire.
How about this kid, huh?
We're at the 4-minute mark on the left side. In the lane.
Big time dagger.
Try to pack it inside. Jump shot.
How about that, Gus?
Out on the right wing. From the corner! Shots off.
What a rebound! It's mine.
They work the perimeter. He fires it up, and he can't get the bounce. He gets the rejection. Off the mark. Snags the offensive rebound. Inside. On the outside. Can finish. In the paint. Second team foul. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You've really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Another great second-year player here, Bill. Underclassmen are a big key for any successful program.
He's still young, but the coach has him out there for a reason. He tends to make the right decisions out there, which means more playing time for him. A simple concept that applies to everyone, regardless of age or experience.
No good.
Rebound and run.
They work the perimeter. Turnover, he'll want that one back. Out on the left wing. We are at the 2-minute mark. Looking for a good shot. Jump shot. No.
That's exactly what coaches love to see from their D. After a shot's gone up, a great checkout and rebound.
Change of possession. The Hoosiers have been getting contributions from multiple players here tonight.
When everybody wants to win, everybody will do what it takes to win. That's what we're seeing, Gus. Five guys making the moves they need to get the victory. We'll be right back.
the Hoosiers running their zone offense.
This particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Dump it inside. Fires. Ha-ha! Can you say tough place to play, Raph? This crowd is fired up. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside.
Put a little English on it.
Around a minute remaining. The Hoosiers are now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
In the lane. Shots off. Pulls down the rebound. On the right side. Ah, he got it up and in. He stood his ground there, Coach.
Great anticipation.
How about a second look at this alley-oop?
Why not? The delivery, the finish, the athleticism. Send it in, big fella. It is remarkable.
Baseline inbound. He missed it. Stay tuned for the road to the Final Four. And here is our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who has been doing what.
Let's check in and take a look at how both sides are doing with the keys to the game. Storms working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
On the left side. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Way to get up, big fella.
The Hoosiers set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, it's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
The Hoosiers are a poor free throw shooting team, Coach.
Boy, that is a bad characteristic to have.
Could spell trouble. Get it down on the low block. Up and in. Ha ha! Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the left of the circle, and he can't get the bounce. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. On the right side. Fires. Off the mark. Grabs the board. He fires away. No.
Makes them so competitive on the glass.
Now they work it around the perimeter. And we're going the other way. Inbounds play on the baseline. Jump shot. He missed it. Hungry for the ball. Out on the left wing. He goes for three. And no!
Oh, competitive, Gus.
And he's fouled. Obviously too aggressive here defensively.
You really got to know your limitations, Gus.
Here's another solid junior build.
Juniors and seniors are such important pieces of any college team. Having experienced kids like him, it can really help coaches and reinforce team philosophies.
He got it. The ball handler is in trouble. And he lays it up and in. On the outside. He can't get it to go.
And he looks to outlet.
On the wing. Fired. Shots off.
See, reacting. How alert, Gus.
They work it around the perimeter. Jump shot. The junior. On the low block. Fires. And he can't get the bounce. Cross court. Jump shot. Off the mark.
Give me that.
On the left side. He shoots from downtown. No. Rips it down. Out on the wing. He missed it. There for the rebound. And lays it in. On the outside. Fires. He can't get it to go.
Dominating the glass.
Jump shot. Buck. Down on the low block, trying to work it inside. And he can't get the bounce. They work it around the perimeter.
Inside.
On the left side. He shoots from the corner. Off the mark. Takes the board.
Nice pass to the low block.
Fires. No.
Get out and fill.
In the post. He strokes it.
Perfect.
Top of the key. Can't elude the trap.
Great defensive trap there. That's almost textbook, Gus. These kids can play. Just a nice feed on the back cut.
Shots off.
See the floor. We can get some easy, fast breaks.
Lobs it. And we'll get a change of possession. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Coach.
As a coach, when your team is playing together like this, all you can do is sit down and enjoy the moment. We all know how fast things can change.
The Hoosiers now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
He attempts the three. And he buries the three. Bill, they're running their offense through the high post.
Doing a great job running their offense. Working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
On the wing. In the lane.
It's good.
The Hoosiers in their four around one motion.
Dribble drive, the ability to understand when to put it on the deck and when to screen.
Way out on the right wing. He fires it up. He missed it. Didn't seem as though anything was going to stop him on that take, Coach.
Because that's a great take. Drive into ecstasy. He drove with conviction and was rewarded with the hoop.
On the right side. Jump shot. And he can't get the bounce.
Get out and fill.
Out on the wing. He shoots from the corner. Comes up empty from deep. On the left side.
Put a little English on it.
Good find on the backdoor cut.
Just an outstanding delivery right there on the money.
Nice rejection. Now we've got a turnover. Dump it inside. In the lane. Off the mark.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
On the left side. He shoots from the corner. No luck from downtown. Now they work it around the perimeter. Around 8 minutes remaining. Ah, he got it up and in. Top of the key. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, because they're high percentage shots. They just got to be completed.
The Hoosiers set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Fired! The sophomore! Bill, they're running their offense through the high post.
Doing a great job running your offense. Working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Way out on the right wing. Up and in. The Hoosiers on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
In the post. Jump shot. Shots off. Got it in the low block. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. On the right side. Shots up, but he misses his target. And he's there with the power jam. Out on the right wing. Fires. And hits. They work it around the perimeter. 6 minutes left on the game clock. In the post. And he lays it up and in.
The great backdoor play.
Just a terrific look to the cutter. Going strong to the tin for the easy finish.
Way out on the right wing. Durham handles the pass. No!
Oh, physicality!
Chavis takes the pass. Jump shot. It won't fall! York handles the feed. We're at the 5 minute mark. Now they work it around the perimeter. Looking for a good shot. And lays it in. Durham gets the ball. Fires. He can't get the bucket to fall. Copeland receives the pass. He throws it up from downtown. And he is no good from downtown. York with the ball. We're at the 4 minute mark. Durham receives the ball. He launches a three. He misses from long range. Porter gets the pass. He puts up the tray. Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. It's so important to take good shots, and not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
Feed the low post. He blocks the shot. Porter receives the pass. No. Ivy takes the feed. He doesn't get the hoop.
Inside.
3 minutes left on the game clock. He got there in time.
Great knowledge of the game.
The Hoosiers have been getting some great production from their bench, Bill.
Well, if you have foul problems, they can step in. They can assist you on the glass, guard their guy, and if they get some points, what a bonus.
Ball coming in from the sideline. The Hoosiers running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Cross court. He fires from long range. He buries it from downtown. looking for a good shot. He throws up the shot. Can finish. The Hoosiers. And now getting set up for around one.
If you don't help out, they just kill you.
Tup it inside. 2 minutes left on the game clock. Duncan handles the feed. Jump shot. Off the mark with the shot. McDowell gets the ball. And he misses the shot.
Put a little English on it.
They work the perimeter. Got it up and in. Top of the key. Fires. He gets the shot to fall.
That was a great play there, Coach.
It's really good offensive position to feed the guy in the high post area. If he can play, it opens up many different scoring opportunities.
He lets it go. And he can't hit the shot. York receives the ball. Now we've got a turnover. Timeout on the floor, ladies and gentlemen. More CBS Sports coverage after this. Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. Now they work it around the perimeter. In the lane, he drains the bucket. Marshall gets the pass.
It looks like they're going to slow the game down by fouling Gus. The obvious strategy at this point. Clock management, Gus. That's what it's all about now. Stopping the clock in order to get back into this game.
And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do.
And yet another stoppage and yet another foul.
And why not?
The Hoosiers are not the greatest free throw shooting team.
Anything free, you just have to convert, Gus.
Shot. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Copeland with the ball. He tries the three. Misses from the outside. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Young man's just a freshman, but has demonstrated that he can play at this level.
Being a freshman can be intimidating, but the key is to find out different ways to contribute to the team. It doesn't always have to be scoring. If he can do the little things and play strong defense, he'll be helping out his team.
And we're back ready to get things going again after the timeout. On the wing. He fires away. Misses from long range. And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. With the free one. No good. Pulls it in. Ready to get things going again after the timeout. On the left side, he shoots from long range. It's no good. And here we have our players of the game, Bill.
Two great players, Gus. You came in with a mindset that they were going to make a difference tonight.
That concludes our presentation on CBS Sports. For Coach Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson, saying so long.